the service was over, Pastor called me out and he prayed for me. He prayed for me because last year, I remember I was so sick. You know, I could hardly manage. Every week I'm sick. Every month I'm sick. I'm just sick. My kids, I'm always in pain. And, you know, sometimes it's hard on my children because they come home and, are you well? Are you still in pain? They prayed, they did everything that they possibly could. But the pain was always there. I went to work and I'm always in pain, I'm always sick. But that day, on Christmas Day, when the pastor called me out and he prayed for me,
yes.
You know, sometimes people say they pray for you, but when pastor calls you and he prays for you, he's getting a direct direction from God. And he doesn't just do something because he knows you. He does it because he's asked to do it by the power of Almighty God. And when he prayed for me that day, the 25th of December, from that day I realized, yes, I may get sick now and again, but I realized all that ache and pain that I used to undergo is no longer there. Sometimes when the pain tries to come on, I just rebuke it in Jesus' name. I was prayed for, I'm healed, I'm delivered, so I have no time for that. I remember one day, Sister Crystal said, "Mommy, you know, I realized that since Pastor prayed for you, I don't hear a complaint and anything." Simply means when God does something for you,
somebody's
going to know. You know, He not only does it for you and you alone. Whatever God does for you, it is to encourage somebody else. Because I'm sure it has encouraged my daughter to know that her mother was sick. And to see that the pastor prayed, she saw she was healed. Sick anymore. You know, so I just want to give God thanks, you know, for being there and for giving us a leader. So many times you talk about the goodness of Jesus, yes, but sometimes we have to remember the persons that God has set in our lives. Because He has placed them there for a purpose. And today I just want to say thank you, Pastor. Thanks to His wife for always being there for us as a body. Sometimes you slip and fall. But as a father gathers his children, he's there to correct and to instruct us. Just continue to pray for me, so I continue to look for Jesus.
When I looked at the situation we were in, I got taken away by this man and, you know, everything I held my neck and all of that. I'm just looking back and I'm saying, look at all these dead, some young ladies. And I got taken away and I was in the heart saying some God. I have to really thank God because I could have been one of those young ladies that was taken away, saints of God, and abducted, saints of God. But I am here standing in His presence, saints of God.
Praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord.
And a big good morning if you are not feeling so hot. I have to share this with you, with my church members. It's so long and it's so hard, and it's like a journey, you don't have no ending. I buried my nephew 2 Sundays ago. I buried my next nephew yesterday. And I buried my niece and the baby and my son Sunday coming. However, it had a lot of up and down. I was supposed to be baptized last week Sunday. My nephew was so dear to me that when he was sick and his foot was cut off, that doesn't stop him. He would call me and he would say, "Auntie, if you didn't have a mother like you, why me no know?" Because then he lost his mom way back. So whenever I'm having a problem with my kids, you know, the wife would be the one I'll call and he would know. And if me not telling, he would hear it. That was by talking to the pastor, and I started to cry. And it's funny because during my tears, somebody told me that tears is a language that God understands. And during my tears, I said something to him. And what I said to him, it just like utterance, and I was saying it. And he said, he turned to me and he said, I will minister, do the service, the funeral for your niece and your son, and I will do it. You don't think nothing about pay no money. I will do it. I'm saying, but one minute and they say, and you they ask me, I know you they say. He said, because of what you just said to me. I said, what did I say to you? He said, you don't know what you just said to me. And I said, no. I'm crying. I'm sitting here because I don't know what else to do. I'm sitting here and I cry. And you said, what did I say to you? And the pastor said, lady, I want you to come to my church this Saturday. And I want you to come to my church the next Saturday. And I want you to baptize in my church. And I said, no. I have already found a church that I'm comfortable with. I was at the morgue when my pastor called me. He didn't know where I was. And he called me and said, I won't take you. I know it's a time, you know, when me know you go through, you go through. And, you know, I just want to check up on you. I'm saying, pastor, oh, you know, I hear somebody know what I mean. He said, you know what? And the pastor said to me, I'm still not giving up on you. Because them not baptized yet, so we still want you. And he said to me, oh, we have internet, and we have, all you have to do is bring a TV, and I tell him I have one of them. And he said, bring a TV and we will do the flash. I mean, this pastor was ready, I'm telling you, ready. He said, he called me every day, every minute he called me, even while I'm sitting here. He called me and I told my daughter not to, you know, say the call because I'm in church. And I'm saying, what does this man see and what did I say to him? And until now, church, I don't know what I said to the gentleman. And the gentleman is not telling me what I said to him because I know I did not say anything to him. And the parlor, bear with me, the parlor called me. Check me that the price raised. I called Sister Alice. I didn't, you know, know. I called her and I said, I said, no man, something wrong. Anyways, when I went downtown to meet up with some other family member, I saw Sister Alice passing going work. Somebody knocked their butter flakes, the juicy leaf glass, but she didn't see. But however, she comes straight in. She go where she was going, come back, and she comes straight in. So I was talking to her and I started to cry. And she said, don't worry yourself, man, you are all right. And she called because she went out to go work. I got another call from the parlor again, the money gone up. Instead of the money going down, the money going up. They said the baby too big to put on stuff, so they have to put it at the side. So they had to widen the casket. Alright, we say, okay, but we tell them we don't have no more money. And we say, well, may I tell them what's going on? Then yesterday again, he called me again. And he said to me, the money gone up again. Because the hole isn't big enough. First, I said, first you tell me that me not to put in your money, where the terminate will be. You tell me again, I mean, what's going on? But you know what? Everything all right. It just all right. Okay, yes. You got enough, how much you say you got enough? You said 300,000. I said, all right. You understand? That will be all right. When I went home, I cried and I went home and I said, God, you said I'm going to stand on your word. You said to me that you will carry me. You say you will lift me like an eagle when the storm, they go right around me. And now is the time me I ask you, me I post you, me I tell you, I'm asking you. Just let me prove. Say, are you in a control and you have this spirit and you are spirit. Whatever comes, Satan bring. I'm telling you, saying, Satan fight me. When me tell you say they fight me, this morning me come to church and me wake up, me go funeral yesterday and say, all right, me they come to church this morning. And when me get up to come to church, when we get up to come to church, we can't find the shoes, we can't find the clothes when we are ready. When it starts out the night before, we come to church. We go and I have a reception, we go and walk up and so. We can't find the thing that I put on. We can't find the shoes because the shoes hurt me. I said, Lord, don't make you hurt me. When I walk down the stairs, I don't come, the lady come up to me and say, where you going? I said, may I go to church? She said, no, you're not going to church. We have 2 weeks. Grave digging, we don't do. And you, we need to carry the people. We say, all right, you don't want the one? Thank you. Because nothing important to me, me and our church. Yeah. If you want the van is right there, I'm going to take you out of the one. Can I tell you, from members who don't know, this pastor and his wife, and just about everybody, let me tell you something. Say, me not left this a church, yeah. Ain't going nowhere. This man is hearing directly, yes, from God. He said, me don't want the fear. Me don't want to know say, what my church full of people. Maybe me can't see one, but two and one. Say, that's a word, you know, any pastor said, they say, come and bring the offering. They did the offering for them, so we good. We know business what you want to do. But pastor, we said, no, let me go. Hold on. Because I saw you hold on the pool. I saw the devil and I'm out of flesh. I'm blood. But me ask, no, no, let me go. And I'm still holding on and I have my eyes on the water. Yes. Right. So I just want to bring my adopted daughter, my adopted son, my grandson. I'm not happy with God, but I know more don't follow me, because they have to go.
Amen.
Check out your turn a message to a message, know the messenger arrived. Committed to the journey, so me now go backslide. Looking through the spirit and the physical eyes. Ooh, to God me testify. Know me are the worker, God are the boss. My whole life, he endorsed. Take me from the mud and put me in a